Are you looking to live stream with your Panasonic camera? Whether you have an old G7 like this one, or maybe you have a new Panasonic G6, or any other camera in between, in this video, I'm gonna walk you through everything you need to know in order to get started, from the hardware to the software, as well as the best settings for your camera to achieve the best quality stream. Hey, what's going on, guys? C. Santos here, and this channel is all about helping you and inspiring you to create content with whatever means necessary. So if you're interested in learning about technology, gear, or other ways of creating content, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell for notifications. All right, guys, so first things first is hardware. Now, everything I'm gonna mention in this video is linked in the description down below, from the hardware to the software and all of the stuff that I use to make these videos. I appreciate you guys who use these links. They help support this channel, so if you're ever looking to support, just shop through those links. It really helps out. Now, obviously, you're going to need a Panasonic camera that has an HDMI port or a USB port. In this case, my G7 only has an HDMI port. Now, if you have a new camera, like let's say the G100 that has a USB port, you have the ability with just a simple USB cable and Panasonic's software for you to be able to begin live streaming immediately without any other hardware. However, the quality of the stream is going to lack. I don't recommend it unless you just want to simply get a clean and dirty setup without having to worry about anything else. But if you're looking to achieve a high quality stream, I highly recommend you get a capture card. In this case, I'm using a Camlink 4K. I picked this up off of OfferUp for like $80. I think these run for a little over $100 nowadays. I highly recommend you use this versus a USB connection. Reason being, the quality through the USB on these cameras or even any other camera that has a USB out in order for you to transmit to a computer, the quality is not the best. So the other thing you're gonna need all depends on whether or not you're gonna need to live stream for over 30 minutes, which is usually about the battery life of these cameras. And I highly recommend this either way. And that is a dummy battery. So this little dummy battery connects to a power adapter that connects to wall outlet, which allows and gives your camera the ability to pretty much have it on all day, 24 hours a day, if you're doing a 24-hour live stream or something. So if you're using a capture card, the next thing you're gonna need is obviously a cable to connect from large HDMI over to micro HDMI. In this case, I actually use an adapter. Reason being is because you can get this adapter to connect to pretty much whatever linked HDMI cable you have. I've used this with over 50 feet of HDMI cable and I haven't had any issues at all. I do highly recommend you get this versus just getting a set length, because then you can just get whatever length you want, or maybe you have an HDMI cable laying around already. And like I mentioned, an HDMI cable. So this connects to this adapter here, nice and snug. And then this connects to here. And there you go. That's pretty much all the hardware you need if you're looking to use the HDMI port, obviously. So this connects to the side. And then this connects to your computer. And besides the computer, that's all you need in order to get started. Now to my left here, you can see it's all set up and configured. However, just letting you know, this computer is 10 years old and it can run a 1080p stream just fine. The second I move the settings over to 4K on OBS, which is, by the way, the software we're using, it's free, it just does not work at all. So I highly recommend if you're looking to do anything more than 1080p, 4K, multicam, let's say, you're gonna need a beefy computer like this one here to my right that can do all of that with a better capture card than what I have, and you have nothing to worry about. Or if you're just doing a single camera stream, just using the Camlink 4K, and it does 4K out just fine. So now moving on to software. Like I mentioned a second ago, I'm using OBS on this laptop. It's free, just download it, install it, and it has all of the drivers for your computer set up. Now, unless you're looking to do some sort of output to a different platform, or you're looking to create one stream that goes to separate different streams, obviously, there's other paid platforms like StreamYard, XSplit, that can do a bunch of fancy things. But if you're just looking to get started and you don't want to pay anything, obviously OBS is a great way to get started. So whether you're using XSplit or any other software, we can begin getting our camera set up for the best settings. Now, this is something that you probably want to do before you actually connect your camera to your computer or to whatever system you're using. So first things first, if you're going to be transmitting 1080p quality out to your live stream, you're going to want to make sure the settings on this camera are set to 1080p and the exact same frame rate that you're going to be using. Reason being is if you have this thing set to 4K, this camera is going to downsample over to the Camlink and it's actually going to create a lag. I've seen it at least with the G7. I don't know about the other cameras, but it's having to downsample that and then send it over into 1080p. So in order to get around that, just make sure you go into the settings and then you're going to want to go down to TV connection and select the quality here. So obviously 4K, 1080p, 1080i, 1080i is interlaced. You don't want to mess with that. Just go to 1080p And then the other thing too is go into the settings on your camera. In this case, obviously, I'm already set up to 1080p, but in the case if you didn't have it set up, you're gonna wanna go to the record quality settings and switch over to 1920 by 1080 at 30 frames per second, unless you wanna do 60 frames per second. The more frames, however, that it's transmitting to your computer, the harder it's gonna work. Most people, 1080p 30 is fine, but if you're doing a 4K stream, you can go ahead and switch over to 4K. That way the cam link is getting the right signal or whatever capture card you're getting, and it's all having to work a lot harder than it needs to. So just keep that in mind, guys, that 4K, even on an old system like this, it's very hard on it. It stutters a lot, it doesn't run really well, but 1080p on most old laptops, even some mid-grade entry-level laptops that are new nowadays, can barely run 1080p streams. Now, besides the record quality settings that I just mentioned, you're also gonna wanna choose the best picture profile for your setup. Now, the thing about live streaming is you're not gonna have the ability for you to change much on the color grading side. OBS does allow you to do some tweaking in post, but it does end up using some computer resources, so just keep that in mind. But if you're looking for the best settings out of this Panasonic G7, for example, right out of the camera, you're gonna wanna go into your photo style settings, go to standard, and then I have them listed right here on the right. So you're gonna wanna set contrast to +1, sharpness to -2, noise reduction to +2, and saturation to +1. So again, this is actually adjusting the image in the camera and just sending it directly into the cam link and into OBS. So you're not having to do any crazy color adjustments in post. Now, besides the best video settings that I just mentioned, you're also going to make sure you get the best audio settings set up on your camera. If you're using the microphone port, in this case, I have the shotgun mic set up right over me, so that way I don't have to worry about a lav like I'm wearing right now in the video or a podcasting mic. However, if you do have that set up, just keep in mind that whatever input you have set up into your computer, that you're going to want to make sure that you have the audio synced. Sometimes what happens is when you have a device like the CamLink connected, there's gonna be like a lag between the audio and the video. So you'll see your lips move before your audio actually moves, and you're gonna wanna adjust that, or vice versa. Sometimes it's the video that lags versus the audio that lags. You have the ability in OBS to adjust that. Just make sure you get that right before, obviously, you get your live stream started. Now, last but not least, live stream settings. These are probably the most important things you need to know in order to get the perfect quality live stream for your audience. Don't blame the camera or the hardware, because if you get this wrong, you're gonna have a really bad quality looking stream. Now, the bitrate settings can be easily adjusted within whatever software you're using. In OBS, you just go to settings, and then you go to the stream settings, and you can adjust the output based on obviously where you're sending your live stream to. Now, in the case of YouTube, like I'm going to be showing you how to do that, for example, YouTube wants at least 3000 to 6000 megabytes per second when you're live streaming 1080p 30 frames per second. Now, obviously, if you want to do a 4K stream or you want to do a 1080p 60 frames per second stream, it all depends on what you're doing. You're going to want to take a look at their blog, and it tells you exactly what you need. Now, the other thing too is you want to make sure that you actually have the ability for you to actually live stream with this amount of data per second, because if you can't and you're telling OBS and your streaming software to do that, you're going to have a bunch of lost frames, and you'll even see it in the back end of whatever platform you're using. It's really easy to mess this up, guys, because I've run multiple live streams, multi-cam streams, and it's easy to get the settings wrong, and then you're wondering why your stream looks really bad. And that pretty much covers everything you need to know in order to get started live streaming with your Panasonic G7. Now, if there's anything that you think I missed, please comment down below if you have further questions. This video idea actually came from a commenter on another video I made about the G7. Thank you for that. I've actually been wanting to make this video for a while now, and I hope this video helps you guys on your journey of creating content for your channel or your business. Like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, I have everything linked in the description down below, all the hardware, all the software, all the gear that I used to shoot this video. Please have a look at those links, and thank you guys so much for watching and getting to the end of this video. I appreciate all the feedback and all the comments you leave. So if you have any questions regarding live streaming or any other questions regarding a Panasonic camera, leave them down in the comments below. I appreciate you guys for watching, and as always, have a great day.